Hello, this is Cristi. Let me show you how you can assemble a sequence in Descript. I see a lot of questions from beginners who don't know how to assemble a sequence from scratch. A sequence is a multi-track timeline where you can align multiple tracks, video or audio, and have them play in sync. And then when you create a composition from that sequence, you can make cuts and edits, and they will all be made to all of the tracks inside the sequence. So this is important if you're editing interviews or you need two video tracks side by side to be edited together. And a common mistake that people do is they assign the track of the first speaker to the main timeline in the composition, the script track, and then they apply the second one on top of it, which is wrong. Let me show you how it's done wrong. You go to the files, to the media bin at the top, and there's two files they have in this project. This is Cristi, it's me, and my guest Chris. So a common mistake is people just drag this first file into the script right there. They may transcribe it. They may not transcribe it. I'm going to switch to video because this is a video file right there. And then they open the timeline and make it a bit taller perhaps. And then they grab the second file and drag it on top here and align it properly like this. Well, this may look like it's working at first, but as soon as you make any cuts in this track down here, the top track becomes out of sync because this is not the way you do it. So this is wrong. I'm going to undo and delete this whole thing here and show you how it is done properly. Okay, so here we go. I have closed that one. So I'm back to my project that has nothing in it. And I see that a lot of people rely on the automations. For example, if you record your interview in Riverside or Squadcast, these applications and many others, they may have integrations that automatically send the files from the recording application to Descript, and they automatically have Descript assemble that sequence for you. The problem with that is that if something goes wrong or something is off, you don't know where to fix it and how to fix it. So this is why I'm showing you how to build a sequence from scratch. So here we go. Go back to the media bin. And again, the same two files, Chris and Cristi, two people. I'm going to click on the first one and hold down the shift key to select the second one. You see they're both highlighted. If you have any files in between, you can also use the command or control key to click on the first one and then the other one. So it's important to have them all selected together. Once they're all selected together, you can see this button here, Create Sequence. Let's do that. Create a sequence. And as soon as you do that, the sequence editor opens up. So if I make this taller, sometimes Descript has a bug, which if you pull to make it taller, it doesn't work. I'm going to just Command Shift to minus, and then there you go to zoom out a little bit. And you look at my editor right here. So you see I have the two tracks. I have Cristi and Chris. I can actually click inside of this track header to rename them. So I'm going to say Cristi and click on the second one and Chris. The name is also shown on the file. So, you know, it's up to you if you want to do it. So there you go. These are the two files in the sequence. And you can see when I'm talking, Chris is not talking. When he's talking, I'm not talking, and so on and so forth to the end of this. So this is step one. I created the sequence. Also inside of the sequence, you have several controls that you can use to change the files. For example, let's suppose my audio is not loud enough. I can click on this track before I make any cuts or deletions. I can click on my track and go to audio here and change the volume. Perhaps I can click and drag to increase the volume on my track only. If I want to increase the volume on Chris's track as well, click on that. And then again, you can drag to click on it. Another thing you can do in here is you can control sound, studio sound for every track on its own. Because if you apply the studio sound in the composition, it will apply it to all the tracks. But here, maybe only my track needs studio sound and not my guest. I can click on my track and tick the box for studio sound. And that will turn it on just for my track. Again, I can click on his track also, turn that on as well. And another advantage of doing it inside the sequence is that I can individually control the level of studio sound applied to each track, as opposed to overall the same for all of them. So that is one advantage, again, of the sequences. Okay, so I am done in here. By the way, I'm not doing any more stuff in here. So the only thing that I may want to do is rename this. So at the top here, click inside of that little text box and say, both speakers. There you go. I've given it a name. I like to give names to things so I know what they are and stay organized. I'm done here. Click done. And here we go. I am back to my media bin. Let me zoom in again. Back to my media bin. And now here we go. There is a new folder here called sequences. Inside of that folder, if you click that arrow to open it up, you see both speakers, that sequence that I just created. Grab that and drag it into your empty composition right there. Release, and there you go. There is my conversation with the script because the files have been transcribed. If the files have not been transcribed, it still allows you to create a sequence, but you can go and actually transcribe the files after you do it. So you can right-click on a file. In my case, I've transcribed already, but I can say retranscribe, or if you have not, you transcribe them. So there you go. So then the script shows up. When I add this video sequence to my composition, because my composition was not video to start with, Descript says, you know, looks like you just added a video. Would you like to switch composition to video? Yes, I do. Switch that, and there you go. I've got a video area here, and you can see if I put my mouse over this, it shows me the two video files that I added. The tracks inside of that sequence, they are now exposed here as individual layers. If I click somewhere in the text, you see both videos show up. And if I click outside of this canvas area, you can see them on the side as well, as layers. So this is another nice thing about sequences. You create these individual tracks inside the sequence, and then those tracks are exposed in here outside of the sequence in your composition so that you can manipulate them individually. So if I want to make my video larger, I can click on it and move it around anywhere I like. I can fill the screen with my video. I can resize it like this. And there you go. My video is a full screen. It doesn't mean that my guest's video is gone. I can do a picture-in-picture situation where I can click outside of this area to deselect, and I see both layers, and I click on Chris's layer now, which is now behind mine, yeah? So I can right-click in here and say, select layer, Chris, and I can also right-click again and say, layer order, bring to front, yeah? So there's my Chris's video, my guest's video there. So I can click his video and move it around, not mine, sorry. I can click his video, move it around. I can also resize it. I can double-click to crop it like this. Double-click to exit and move him in the corner. There you go. So I have a picture-in-picture set up with my sequence. So these are all the advantages. And the nicest thing, which I mentioned at the beginning, is look, if I expand the timeline, you will see now that the timeline contains both videos. Yeah. So if I scroll around, you see the green ones is Chris and the blue ones is me. The waveform is colored differently to match the speaker label that you have assigned to each portion of the audio. So this is the advantage of sequences. This is how you assemble a sequence. And now, if I make any deletion, let's say I want to remove this entire paragraph from here, I will just delete it. It's gone. And now it doesn't mean that I've lost sync. The sync is still going to work and Chris is still going to play in those other areas that I haven't deleted. Everything's going to play in sync and you don't lose anything. And when you delete in here, by the way, you do not delete from inside the sequence. This is another misconception that beginners have. They think that if they delete some text in here, it's actually gone from the sequence. Well, it's not. Look at this. I go to the beginning and I say, hello, this is Cristi. I'm deleting that, right? Delete that. And I'm now playing it. Welcome to the meet. I'm not saying, hello, this is Cristi anymore, right? But watch this. If I right click on the timeline and say, edit sequence, it's going to take me to the sequence and look, hello, this is Cristi is still here. If I play it, hello, this is Cristi, well, yeah. So sequences are edited non-destructively. You can create any number of compositions from the same sequence and you can edit them in different ways, cut different words out, cut different gaps out, and change orientation, vertical, horizontal, just in those compositions. It will never affect the underlying sequence on your project. So this is the advantage of sequences versus compositions. I hope this was useful. Feel free to ask any questions in the comments. And if you enjoy these videos, feel free to like them, subscribe to my channel. And, you know, let me know in the comments which other videos would you like me to make, any other questions you have. And maybe I will also see you in my Media Makers Club membership, where we can do weekly Q&A sessions. And you have access to my courses, including a Descript course. So thank you again for watching. See you on the next one.